Hi, graphic designers. Today we're going to be an illustrator and we're going to be looking at fonts. I'm Kelly Barkhurst and I am the designer for Designer to Full Stack. And on this YouTube channel, I show things from graphic design to web design and coding. So if that feels interesting to you, then please subscribe. All right, so a trend that I've been seeing recently is album covers and artists using typography that reminds me of record covers from my childhood that my mom and dad had. They have flourishes or swashes that are reminiscent of 60s and 70s folk artist album covers. And so recently I was looking at Leanna Crawford's album and I just thought it was such a beautiful font. I wanted to know what font it was. So this is how, if you find a font on a design somewhere, you can do an experiment to figure out what type of font it is. So the first step is to find an image. And I will actually walk you through the steps that I used. So I used whatfontis.com. All right, so let's start from the beginning. And I am going to drop the album cover into where it says to drop. All right, now it's asking me to crop the text. So I'm actually going to delete the boxes that I don't need or want. And it's okay if I can't get that one deleted. And we will expand this. And my goal is to get Leanna Crawford. All right, so now I use next step. Okay. I understand. Oh, we need to go back. And so that might happen. Let's see. We'll go back. What happened? We do not. We want to get rid of these again. It's not letting me get rid of that one. Okay, so we can do this. And then this. Let's see if it will let me get rid of that. No, I really can't. All right. We'll try again. Okay, so this might happen to you as well. And let's just open our image in Photoshop. We will crop out just the part that we want. Save as desktop, just the words. All right, perfect. Let's try again. So previous step. And sometimes it really is trial and error in everything that we do. All right, this is feeling better. Okay, oh, is it gonna let me expand it? There we go, next step. All right, so here we go. We can optimize the contrast we need to, brightness. I think it's looking pretty good. Next step. I understand. Okay, so when there's an X, that means I cannot change the letter. So I need to say activate all letters, and now I can type in the letter. Okay, here. It did a pretty good job. We're gonna type in the O and the D. So you can see that all of the letters that had their flourishes or the swash, it didn't know. Okay, so we say next step. We can display only free fonts. In this case, I want to know what it is, so I don't want just free fonts. And it did not do a good job this time. Yeah. Isn't that interesting? I'm not going to activate all the fonts this time. Okay. When I didn't activate the fonts, it did find it. So without doing the flourish and the swashes, it did find it. And that's actually pretty interesting. So it is Wayfinder, and you can get that from myfonts.com or Wayfinder. If you search for Wayfinder, it is part of Adobe Fonts. Okay, so what I find interesting about this is when it had a hard time finding the flourish fonts, those were alternatives. And also, it's kind of hard to see what all of the letters look like when I'm looking on Adobe Fonts. So if I click into one of the fonts, right, I'm not actually seeing all of the specialty glyphs that I can use. So if I come in to Illustrator, how Adobe Fonts, this one is probably not by default installed. So if I select text and I type in Wayfinder, and I don't want the regular, I need to look at the Find More tab. And then I can see I have all of these other kinds. And I have this little logo to the right that says add. Add this font. Okay. You can see that it's starting to load and be added. Once it's added, I could select this. And this time, if I put in Wayfinder, I now have regular and bold. Okay, so that's how you add a font that's part of Adobe Fonts if you have a subscription. All right, so looking here, if I type in just by default, Leanna Crawford, you can see that it looks different than what is on the album cover. And what we're missing is these flourishes, these swashes that are added to the capital L, to the lowercase a, and to this D. So how do I get those? The answer in Illustrator is you're going to go to Window and Glyphs. So it's under Type Glyphs, okay? So this is your Glyphs window. And you can see that you have a font selected down at the bottom. And these are all the different characters or glyphs that are available to you. So about here in the middle, you can see that there are variations of the A and the B and the D. Not every letter, but many letters have variations. So what you would do is you would click with your mouse the letter that you want changed. So if it's selected, and now I can double click this glyph, right? And now I've changed that version of the L. So now if I come to the A, I can search for that version of the A. Here's one with the flourish. All right. The same if I wanted to come into my D, I would select my D and I would look for the variation that I want, and here it is. All right, so it's interesting because these extra glyphs were not able to be defined with what the font website that we were using. It didn't know them, and I also couldn't easily find them when I looked at the Adobe Fonts website. So that can make finding a unique glyph pretty difficult when you're trying to find a font. So look for, you know, what it was able to ID was O's and W's and A's and just plain letters. So look for those. And then remember that you can come into Glyphs and Illustrator to find all your extras. So let's just look and see, you know, there are these beautiful variations. So you could find a P or a W. there's a beautiful A that swashes up to the left. So make sure you don't miss out on all the beautiful extra glyphs that are available to you with your fonts. All right, I hope this helped.